What's going on, everybody? How you guys doing? Listen, I wanted to hit you guys up and talk a little bit about the magic of gratitude and what it can do for your life instantly. So I'm going to wait for a couple people to jump on here. Karen Berry, how you doing? Richie Bello, my brother, how you doing? So, like, I got to tell you, Chuck Studebaker, it's easy. I was thinking this morning about all of the times that I have been at $0 or worse. I mean, and there's been a lot of times in my life where I was like, man, how in the world am I going to make it through this, whatever it is? How you doing, Chuck? Lorena, how you doing? Shelton, what's up? Jeff Sims. So listen, what's up, Jim Weaver? So we've all been there. I mean, unless you were born with a gazillion dollars in your account. Dragon, my brother, how you doing, man? We still need to talk, man. So, hey, Tonetta, how you doing? I'm grateful for you, bro. I'm grateful for you. If you guys don't know who Dragon is, I'm not even going to try to pronounce it. It's Trzaskowski. Is that right? Trzaskowski. Or is it Trzaskowski? So, Dragon is one of the number one salespeople in the world for Mr. Tony Robbins. That dude right there is a badass. And I am very, very grateful. Very, very grateful. Love you too, brother. Thank you for popping in. So, follow that guy, man. He's amazing. Dragon Slayer. That's it. That's it. So you know, I was thinking about this, like all the times in my life that I've been down to zero. I mean zero, like no money, don't know where the next dollar is coming from, got rent to pay, got car payments, got insurance, got this, got that. Oh yeah, and I like to eat. My family, my kids, my wife, we all like to eat. We like to have electricity and gas and all of those things, right? So all of the times that I have been down to nothing, and knowing that I have to take action, right? You know you have to take action. You know you need to create results in your life, but yet you're in that funk. Have you ever, who's experienced this? Come on, tell me. Drop a one if you've ever experienced that. Just tell me if you've ever had that happen. Jennifer Gluckow, how in the world are you? Oh my gosh, it's great to see you. So it's very easy for us as human beings when we are in that place. And if you've never been to that place where you're broke, I mean, so poor you can't pay attention, where you've got like creditors calling you, you've got freaking everything financially just is upside down and you don't know what to do. You don't know what to do. Oh, I missed you. I'm sorry. I watched most of the replay. I missed you though. I'm sorry. But like, here's the thing. The only way that you can get through that, is you have to find some things in your life to be grateful for. And I know that sounds all Pollyanna and it sounds whatever, but if you don't find something. Oh, he asked for me. You should have sent me a text message. I mean, when the unbelievable Jennifer Gluckow and Jeffrey Gittimer ask you to come on to, I mean, just send me a text message. I just missed it. I didn't see it. I apologize for that. So, but listen, when you know what, Jennifer, I'm going to call you. I want to talk to you about interviewing you and or Jeffrey on my new show that I'm doing. So listen, here's what you do. Here's what you do. First off, you know you have to take massive action to get out of a bad financial spot. However, it's very difficult to take the appropriate, because if you take, and I heard Jeffrey Gittimer, I'll be better the next time. You're awesome. I heard Jeffrey Gittimer say on his show yesterday, talking about, like, you know, if you call with the wrong attitude, if you have the wrong attitude and you're taking massive action with the wrong attitude, you're not going to produce the results that you need to produce. So how do you change your attitude? Well, one of the ways that I found most effective in my life is to get out a pen. Where's my Apple pencil? Where did it go? Oh, it's right there. So I get out my Apple pencil, I get out my iPad, I open up my app that I use for notes, and I start writing a gratitude list. And I write everything that I can think of that I'm grateful for. It is gratitude. And once you start focusing on what you have to be grateful for, these comments are like scrolling way up. I can't. Okay. So once you are focused on what is in your life that you have to be grateful for, and you write it down, you've got to write it down, and then you have to contemplate. You have to sit there and really kind of meditate or contemplate on it, focus on it. Imagine what it's going to be like once you start accomplishing the bigger things that are on your gratitude and goal list. You have to let it expand in your mind and work its way into your heart. You have to. I had my oldest daughter. She was here, it was a couple weeks ago, and she was talking. We were talking about this because she's a volleyball player, and she felt like she had a bad game. And I said, well, it's the game is not it what I will call you, Jennifer. I want to have you or maybe both you and Jeffrey Gittimer on my I want to talk to you about interviewing you guys. So and maybe individually too, that would be fun. But so she said, you know, she said, well, that wooden beam up there is too high. I can't touch that, no matter how many times I imagine it in my head. And I said, yes, you can. And she said, no, I can't. And so she jumped up, and it was half-hearted effort, and she didn't touch it. I said, you're actually not too far away from that. You can do it. I said, what you need to do is close your eyes, and visualize over and over and over of you actually touching it. Like you're jumping up and you actually touch it. I need you to visualize it. Close your eyes and visualize it and put gratitude into it and think, I'm grateful for being able to reach up and touch that. And then every time you do it perfectly each and every time in your mind. And she did that. And then she jumped up and boom, she touched it. And she was blown away. And I said, see, it's all what's going on up here. So gratitude, being grateful for whatever you have going on right now, it doesn't matter. If you're upside down in your bank account and you're overdrawn, and I've been there. Trust me, I've been there. I can't even tell you how many times I've been there. I've been there so many times. So, like, but listen, it's okay. Because you can't be a business owner, you can't be an entrepreneur, it's hard to even be alive if you haven't experienced financial hardships in this world. It happens. It happens to everybody. But the way that you get out of that and stay out of that is you've got to train yourself to focus on being grateful. And you're like, but all the wheels fell off my truck and my car and the electric's turned off and everybody's dying and no, they're not, man. Come on. You can be grateful for something. Maybe it's the shower that you can take, or maybe it's the clothes that you can put on your back, or maybe it's the food that you have in your pantry, even if it's a box of ramen noodles. Be grateful. Find something to be grateful for. You wake up and you have your wife, your kids, your girlfriend, your boyfriend, your whatever with you. Be grateful for them and write that stuff down. Write it down. Whatever it is that you're grateful for, write that down. Once you start writing stuff down that you are grateful for, you will magically begin to expand more things into your life, more circumstances, more situations, more opportunities for you to be grateful for. So focus on gratitude no matter where you are. I've been homeless 4 times in my adult life. And I'm telling you that the more I focused on what I didn't have, the more that that expanded. It all goes back to Napoleon Hill's Think and Grow Rich. It all goes back to the law of attraction, the secret, and all of the things that you want to have in your life. It all comes down to what's going on up here. And if you can get this right up here, where you're focusing on the things that you have to be grateful for in your life, where you're focusing on all of that, it's all going to start entering. It's all going to line up with your heart. Once this and this are in alignment, the world becomes magical. Things become magical for you, for your family, for everything that you want to have and create in your life. Remember that the only reason that you're going to fall into a depression or a bad state of mind. Hey, Leah, thank you for being on here. I love Leah Brown. She is amazing. Y'all need to follow her too. So you know, the only reason that you could be in a depression because of your bank account, whether it's a negative or you're at zero or whatever, is because you're focused on what's going wrong in your life instead of what's going right. When you get a piece of paper out and you take a pen and you write gratitude or I am grateful for at the top, and then you say, I am grateful for my life. I am grateful for my ability to make phone calls. I am grateful for whatever it is, write it down. I am grateful for the $1 million account balance I will have 6 months from now. Whatever it is, whatever your goals are, whatever your desires are. I am grateful for my wife. I am grateful for my children. I am grateful for whatever it is. You've got to write that stuff down. It's not just some hocus pocus BS. GG, gotta go, but look forward. Yes, we need to talk. Jen, I'll call you later on. So, you know, thank you for being on here, by the way. You rock. So, that's one of the things that I've done for many, many, many years. And the more that I focus on being grateful, thank you, Leah. Thank you. I'm grateful for you as well. The more that I focus on what I'm grateful for in my life, the more magical things start showing up. They just do. You can call it whatever you want. The law of attraction is real, okay? There is irrefutable evidence that the law of attraction is real, that you attract what you think about and focus on. It's absolutely real. I have thousands and thousands of examples in my life, maybe millions. But at the end of the day, whatever I'm focused on in my mind and in my heart is what I'm going to attract. So when I'm focused on being grateful, when I'm focused on gratitude for the things that I'm creating in this world, gratitude for the people that I'm helping in this world, gratitude for all of my friends, all of my family, everything around me, when I focus my attention on what I'm grateful for, I start attracting more things to be grateful for. So I am, and listen, I am, that's right, Shelton, energy flows where focus goes. It absolutely does. If you wake up and you're like, oh God, I'm overdrawn in my account. I just don't know what to do. Poor me. I promise you that your life is going to continue going into a downward spiral because you're sitting around feeling sorry for yourself. Do something positive, like get a piece of paper out and write down goals every day, twice a day. Grant Cardone taught me that. I'd never heard that in my life till I hadn't. I always focused on writing goals down, but definitely not twice a day. Start writing your goals down in the morning and at night and write down a gratitude list along with them and watch what happens. Do it for 30 days. Try it for 30 days. 30 days, that's it. And listen, it's like when I used to go to Alcoholics Anonymous. We'd say, hey, just come in, give it a go, try staying sober for 6 months, just give it a shot. And if it doesn't work for you, if after 6 months your life sucks still and it's still really, really bad and you're miserable, well then guess what? You can always go back out and drink again and we'll refund 100% of your misery. You can have it. So like, look, just give it everything you have for 30 days. Be grateful. Write it down every single freaking day, twice a day. And watch, I promise you, if you do those things, your life will become magical. Stop walking around being at effect. There's everything in life is cause and effect. There's my brother Doug. How you doing, man? Good to see you. So everything in life is cause and effect. Start being at cause in your life. Start being at cause in your life. Stop walking around letting life affect you. You be at cause. You take control. You be grateful. Stop walking, refund 100% of your misery. That's right. Like that, everything that you're thinking is literally either a deposit into your life or you're taking it away. And if you're sitting there going, well, but I'm overdrawn. You don't understand, Ken. The hell I don't understand. I understand. I promise you I understand. I understand. I've been there. Not only have I been there and been homeless and been broke and had nothing, not one single penny to my name, but I've been without a car. I've been unemployable. I was so bad of an alcoholic, I couldn't get a job freaking doing whatever. Like, it was bad. I remember a real quick story. I worked one day, I was homeless in Seattle, and I met this dude in a bar that owned a moving company. And he's like, bro, I'll give you a job. You can start tomorrow working on a moving truck. And I was like, holy crap. Okay. I did that one day. I said, this is some bull crap right here. Who in the heck wants to do this forever? I ain't doing it. I did it one day. But I made enough money to go drinking that night. So, but like, look, you gotta remember that whatever you focus on, whatever you're thinking about, whatever it is you're thinking about, if you're thinking about what you're lacking in your life and how this person screwed you or that person did you bad or your wife screwed you over, your wife was with your best friend, your husband went out with your best friend or your sister or what, like, hey, you know what? Keep focusing on that and your life's gonna suck. I'm telling you, forgive it. Move on, get better, focus on what you have to be grateful for in your life. I don't care what it is. Maybe it's that, the breath, just the breath. Take a breath and remember that there's a lot of people that woke up this morning in heaven or hell. They're no longer breathing. And your day of this body thing right here, this flesh, that day, the expiration date is coming. And the trick about life is you don't know when that is. Neither do I. I think I'm going to live to be about 97, I believe. And I'm going to have energy all the way up until that last moment. But I don't know that for sure. And the more I focus on what I don't have, the more I'm not going to have what I want in life. So I'm focusing on gratitude. I focus on what I have. And when I focus on the gratitude I have for what I have continues to expand. And that is the way that it works. That's the way it works. Cause and effect. Be at cause in your life. Start today. Start today and make a gratitude list and write your goals down and then write them down again tonight. Shooting for 100 plus. And I am real focused on that. Nice, dude. Well, hell, I'll just join you, man. Let's live to be 110. Let's do that. 110. Me and Shelton, we going down at 110. That's it right there. I'm with you, bro. I'm with you. Let's do that. So like, focus on gratitude. Focus everything you have on gratitude. Listen, I'm very grateful that every single one of you have been on this stream. Thank you. I haven't seen how many of you shared, but I'm grateful if you shared this out. Thank you so much for that. Thank you for everything. I appreciate and love all of you. How about 120? Let's do it. Can I get 125? Let's do 125. I mean, you know, I'm only 49, so that means, I mean, 50 years, 60 years from now, you know, medical technology is going to be so advanced, we'll probably be able to live to 150. There's my, oh, there, Leilani Moore. I freaking love Leilani. She's amazing. I love that woman. Love, love, love. 125. Let's do 125. We're going to live in this flesh right here until 125 years young. Young. But let me tell you real quick, one more quick story. A friend of mine told me one time that he loves, it's morbid, I think, but he loves going to graveyards, old graveyards. And he says, one day I'm standing there and I'm looking down at this tombstone and there's this guy, and y'all have heard, you know, what did you do with your dash, right? And he goes, this guy was like born in 1780 and died in like 1820. He said, and I'm standing there and I'm looking down at his tombstone, and it says, you know, here lies so and so, born in 1780, died, and I mean, so he died at 40 years old or something. And he said, I'm standing there, I'm looking down, and I'm like, I look at the years, and I'm like, all of a sudden it occurred to me, that dude has been down there way longer than he was up here. Way longer than he was up here. He goes, and I saw his dash, and I thought, I wonder what he did with his dash. I wonder what he did with his dash. What are you doing with yours? Are you walking around mopey, feeling sorry for yourself about what you don't have? Or are you ready to change something and start focusing on gratitude? Leilani said, I'm calling 133 years. Me and Shelton going to 125. Leilani, you know women outlive men, so there you go. There you go. So listen, I'm telling you, focus on gratitude. Focus on what you want in your life. Write that stuff down and be grateful for it as if it's already happened. Because you know what? The mind doesn't know the difference between something real and something imagined. That one's a hard one to... Hey, James, how you doing, man? Good to see you, brother. Good to see you. The mind doesn't know the difference between something imagined, if it's clearly imagined, and something in reality. So focus on what you're grateful for. Focus on what you want to create and go into a super expansion mode. You do that and your life will be magical. I'm grateful for all of you. Thank you to everyone who shared. Thank you to all of you who've been on this stream. I'm going to bounce now. Thank you. You guys have an amazing day. And go be grateful. Be grateful and create some gratitude for other people as well along the way. Help others become grateful. Bless them. Bless them. And watch. You'll get blessed. See you later. Peace out.